Well, the idea of the book came about when we're sitting, looking at the protest of the Fees Must Fall movement and actually how it built momentum. And well, I was sitting with Malcolm and said, you know, this is a very important question that we need to answer because, and also next year, I was looking for a project to do for my 40th birthday because I'm turning 40 in 2016, and also that is the 40 years of the 1976 Soweto riots, and we needed to work on something that would actually showcase our commitment to bringing about change. And this came at a perfect time when we then explored to say, what is the problem that is being presented here, and what can we be able to do to challenge ourselves to do something? Because at the end of the day, we're going to be measured by the legacy of the solutions that we put together. And this lended itself to saying there is a solution to this, and how can we use our skills to be able to come to the fore and solve the problem. And so it's a personal project that has personal resonance, but also to be able to see what impact it can have in the country in bringing about education to the solution, to the education crisis that we have currently. Absolutely. And the time that we've spent, you know, I like the Einstein saying that if I had 1 hour to solve a problem, I would use 55 minutes to understand the problem and then the rest of the time to come up with the solution. And that's what the book has been for us, immersing ourselves in understanding the problem, because it can also enable us to come up with the solution. But a solution that is not coming from outsiders, because we lived through that history of the 70s, 80s, and now we are given a mission to say, how do we then craft the solution? We've seen things, people saying, fees must fall, roads must fall. But the big question is, what must rise? And there is an answer to that, that would be able to craft a very elegant solution that requires everyone to be able to contribute to. And also you having business, having the civil society, having the universities contributing to the solution. And towards the end of the book, there is a solution. And that solution also will be expanded in part two, which is going to be a new book. It will make a difference in deepening understanding about our past. And most of the time we don't learn from the past, and therefore we repeat the same mistakes. And we see some of the mistakes being repeated in some of the reforms that have been put in place post-1994. So the difference that it will make is that we need to nip the problem deep in the bud, so to take the root out of the problem so that it doesn't recur over and over again. And so while this is a very historic narrative, but it's not an academic kind of narrative, it comes across like a captivating story and in terms of the stories that have been used in the book, so that it brings about that readability and engages the reader emotionally and actually can make them see, oh, this is how I can actually contribute to the solution. And there are aha moments that come across as you read the book and say, oh, I didn't really know that, that's very interesting. And so it's very engaging in that way, that we can be able to make a difference as a person, and what is the role or action that you're going to implement to change the course of how we solve the problems of education and transformation in society. So the scope of the book start looking at the missionary schools around the 1800s. And the missionary schools had a big role to play in the culture of South Africa, where most people were learning through church, and also in music. A lot of people learned in the missionary schools how to read music and so forth. And then we take you through to the 1910s, when South Africa became a union, and when to 1948, and what happened in the tussle between that time, the emergence of the ANC and so forth, and how the educational policy was formulated, and the roots of Bantu education got planted. And then we go through the Verwoerd years, and in the 70s, the prequel to the 1976 what were the ingredients that emerged for 1976 to become explosive? And then from 1976 to 1994, the transition that we went through. And then we look post-1994 to 2015, how the reform by the ANC government was implemented and the impact that it has had, leading us to the movement of the roles must fall and the fees must fall. So it's a very comprehensive look from the colonial times till 2015, but without necessarily comprehensively covering everything, but we choose certain pivotal moments that we need to focus on that explains how we got to where we are.
What is the question that this book answers?
The big question is, we have it's contained in the title of the book, Free Fall. You know, when you have an object falling, and what is it that is going to actually stop that free fall? And that's where the big question is. Roads must fall, fees must fall, but what is it that is going to stop that fall and help us to rise, reverse the momentum? And it forces us to look deep within ourselves for the creativity to be able to build, rather than to see things falling. But what is it that is going to be built that will be of enduring value, that will stop that free fall? And so that is the main question that we're going to be looking at. What is it going to take to actually stop that free fall?
Who's the audience for this book?
The audience is really wide, because it's important for students to understand what they are struggling against. Because if you don't know what you're struggling against, you cannot come up with credible solutions. But for businesses as well, because if we do not solve the education problem in this country, there's no sustainability for business. And for government, when they look at policies, what are those policies that will actually stop the free fall that we are currently seeing? And also for parents to be able to understand how we got to where we are, and what role can they play to support the future generations. So the scope is quite wide in terms of the readers. There's a lot of people who find it very interesting and engaging.